that I am here now today at Bletchley Park very proudly to unveil the original letter sent to General Sir Stewart Menzies, Chief of the Secret Intelligence Service and Director of Government Code and Cipher School, by General Dwight D Eisenhower, Supreme Commander, Allied Forces Europe, and signed on the 12th of July, 1945. The existence and text of this letter first became public knowledge in September 2010 with the publication of Professor Keith Jeffries' authorised history of MI6, and I am going to say here that Keith Jeffries, sadly, a wonderful historian, passed away recently. It was previously known to me, with a very good reason, that for several years it was hanging in my office when I was Chief of the Secret Intelligence Service, but of course the office was secret, so I knew about it, other people didn't. I was, of course, proud of the letter. General Eisenhower became the first commander, subsequently NATO, and then, obviously, President of the United States. And he is one of the great names of the 20th century. General Menzies is rather less well known, as befits the head of a great Secret Service. But he was well known to me as my predecessor, our third chief, and one of the greatest. An officer who led the service throughout the Second World War and beyond, in a post which, since 1923, had included responsibility for the Government Code and Cipher School, known as GC and CS, throughout the war. And this is the direct forerunner of GCHQ. In August 1939, approximately 200 members of GC and CS came to Bletchley Park. In January 1945, well over 8,000 men and women worked at Bletchley Park, and several thousand more worked at stations inside and outside the United Kingdom. This huge increase in numbers reflected success, outstanding success, and contribution to victory in 1945. Now, as noted, I was consciously proud of the Eisenhower letter. But even as a long-standing officer of the service, and one who had always taken a close interest in service history, I did not fully appreciate to what General Eisenhower was referring when addressing his, I quote, heartfelt admiration and sincere thanks, close quotes, to the director and staff of Bletchley Park with these words, again in quotes. The intelligence which has emanated from you before and during the campaign has been of priceless value to me. It has saved thousands of British and American lives and in no small way contributed to the speed with which the enemy was routed and eventually forced to surrender. And as I have said elsewhere, General Eisenhower didn't write letters like that every day. Here it is. Now, only when you look at the detail of what happened immediately before and during D-Day, and when you see the confidence Eisenhower placed in this intelligence when taking remarkably brave strategic decisions, do his words begin to take on their full meaning. It was vital intelligence from Bletchley Park, and it was supported, of course, by reporting from the brave British agents on the ground in occupied territory, and reporting from the French resistance. And, again, of course, in Eisenhower's mind, would have been the contribution from Bletchley Park to the campaigns in North Africa, Sicily, and the Atlantic, to list the most obvious critical campaigns. In brief, the work done here was a very big deal indeed, although I'm not sure they would have used those words at the time. This letter was written by the Supreme Allied Commander, a great American, to a great but discreet Briton. It was written in the spirit of the unique and special relationship between these two world powers, a relationship which was born here at Bletchley Park on the 8th of February 1941 and continues, as I am in a position to know, in great strength to this day. Above all, it acknowledges and reflects the unique spirit of Bletchley Park and of the men and women who worked here, a spirit captured very well by Bill Bundy, head of the American cricket analyst, who worked in Hut 6 as a young man and later became Assistant Secretary of State, having advised Presidents Kennedy and Johnson. Again, I quote from Bundy. I had other jobs with superb people, important and worthwhile pursuits. But certainly for me, this was the high point. This was a totally dedicated group, working together in absolutely remarkable teamwork. It was an extraordinary group in an extraordinary